Hey everyone, John Chow here from johnchow.com, and welcome to Driving with John Chow. I have the GoPro set up a little differently today. I want to give you a driver's eye view of the new Tesla Model X, especially this windshield. That's my favorite feature of this car, other than the gull wing door. This windshield extends all the way back to my head, so I got the GoPro mounted at the very back, so you can see. I can see the top of the tree. It's pretty cool. Disadvantage, of course, is that the sun comes down and this part is tinted, but it can get hot, especially if you're in very very hot climate like Arizona. Today is not too bad. I mean, it is 79 degrees right now, but still, it's okay. It's okay. Anyway, I want to show you, a little bit more about the Autopilot, how to engage it, and I'm going to use it to drive to lunch. I just dropped off lunch for Sally, and now I'm going to drive to a .com lunch and meet up with a friend. And I figure, well, you actually will see me drive there, and along the way, I'm going to engage the Autopilot, and you can see the car drive itself. The Tesla is equipped with what's called traffic aware cruise control, and it's activated with this stalk down here. So basically what I do is you tap it once and engages the cruise control, and it will maintain the speed of the traffic in front of you. And if you double tap it, it will go into autopilot mode, and it will drive for you and steer for you. Now, the autopilot mode is meant to be only used on the highway. It's not supposed to use it in the city. It can read the speed limits, it can read speed signs, but it cannot read stop signs, like the stop signs ahead. It won't read that, and if it's not following a car, it will just go right through the stop sign. Same thing with red lights, it cannot read red lights as well, so this is why it's only meant to be used on a highway. Future versions, future updates of the software, I'm pretty sure will allow it to read stop signs and red lights, so it will, I'm sure, in future updates. Right now, I think we're at version 7.2. Maybe by version 8 of the software, it will be able to drive on autopilot in the city, read the stop signs, read the red lights and stuff, and it'll stop and all the other good stuff. So, but in the meantime, you can use it on the city. Just be aware that if you see a red light, you're going to have to stop it yourself. The car won't stop. So once I make this turn, I guess then we get on to Alton. I'll engage it, and you'll see how it actually works. But in the meantime, you notice that it has a browser, and I love how nonchalant Tesla is about liabilities and stuff. I remember when I had the Mercedes, I couldn't even use the GPS when I'm driving. Like, I couldn't enter an address. It said that, please pull over and stop because, Mercedes is scared that if you take your eye off the road when you're entering, information, you might crash and they're going to sue Mercedes. And Mercedes disabled the GPS. You have to pull over and stop to enter an address. Or unless you have someone in the passenger seat and the passenger enters the address, that's fine. But Tesla, hey, they don't give a crap. Yeah, I could enter an address, I could do whatever, so yeah. It's kind of cool. Yeah, so that. But it has a web browser. I could actually, while I'm driving, I could actually browse my website. always connected. Anyway, we're coming up to red light. After this red light, I'm going to engage the autopilot. And I like going down this street because this street if you look at the map here, this street has a little curve in it. So it's you're going to see it. You can see the scene. We actually turned by itself and everything. So that'd be kind of cool. Yeah. Oh, and this little button here, turn that on. It tells all the charging stations nearby. And of course, there's no charging station near here. But see, so there's a charging station there. So, if I'm ever stuck looking for a charge and a supercharger is not nearby, I just hit that and it will tell me all the charging stations within the area. Yeah, recenters it. It's kind of cool. The GPS in this thing is by far the best GPS of any car because it's powered by Google. I don't understand why you know, I would pay like $2,000 for the GPS that's in my Jaguar, and it sucks. I never use it. I always use my Google Apps on my phone too, because the Google Maps is so much better. And it's good to see that Tesla actually integrates with Google Maps. And actually, when I'm using GPS, it shows up on here too. So let me just turn it on. There you go. It's on now, and it's driving by itself. And we're going for a turn. Like I said, like it's a green light, but just so you know, like, it doesn't really tell the difference. And the reason we're going fast is because it knows the speed limit of this road, 50 miles an hour. So it's going 55. I don't know why. And we're coming up to a stop, and luckily there is a car ahead, so it will stop for the car. And like, if there was no car, it would just go right for the red light. So this is why you need to be careful when you're using this on the street, right? And it's gonna follow the car and continue. So it's gonna take me to my lunch. I'm going to ramen today. Going at the Diamond Jamboree Plaza. And yeah, there you go. It's kind of cool. And I can wave to you guys. How are you guys? And not looking where I'm going. I shouldn't, like, kind of scary at first, but you know, after a while, you know, my wife used it the other day and she was like, oh, she was so nervous. But, and I must admit, the first time I come up to a turn and the first time I entered this turn, I'm going, I had my hands on the wheel going, okay, is it going to turn? Is it going to turn? And yeah, the first time you use it, it can be pretty disconcerting, but after a while, you just gotta learn to, you know, let the car do its thing. It's helping me hold the steering wheel right now because, yeah, after a while, it wants to make sure that I am not asleep. So it will actually hold the steering wheel, confirm that I'm awake, right? So what will happen if I don't do what it says, it will keep buzzing me to tell me to hold the steering wheel to prove to me that you're not asleep. And if I refuse, like if I just sit there, if I actually did fall asleep, what the car will do is it will pull over to the curb and it will just stop. That's what it will do. Now, this is much, much better than I remember, the Mercedes-Benz S-Class has a limited form of autonomous driving. And every 30 seconds, you're supposed to touch the steering wheel to prove that you're awake, and it can only go in a straight line and just a little turn, but it can't, it's not as advanced as the Tesla's. But the Mercedes system, you have to hold every 30 odd seconds, you got to hold the steering wheel. And if you don't, it will then beep like the Tesla. And if you don't, it will continue to beep. And if you refuse to hold the steering wheel, the system will turn off. System will turn off, and then of course, what will happen? You'll crash, which is really, when you think about it, it's kind of stupid, right? But at least a Tesla, it will actually pull over and it will stop. Okay. So there you go. We're driving and I'm almost at my lunch. It's driving me toward lunch. And you can see that it goes blue. The blue line here, it tells you like it found the line and it will stay within the line. That there is a speed limit, 50 miles an hour. And that's my speed. It's following the car in front. And it will... So, you know, seeing how... Well, this thing works on the street. I don't think it won't be long before Tesla adds, you know, the ability to recognize stop signs and street lights, and then we'll be able to use the system on the street. I said hopefully by version 8. But I'm here for lunch. There's a Diamond Jamboree. I'm gonna turn over and take control, and boom, it turns off. Well, I take control, and now I am total control of the car, and I'm gonna turn in to my place for lunch, and that's basically it. So that's a little more advanced demonstration of the Autopilot system. It's pretty damn cool. So anyway, that's it. Any questions, leave in a comment. I'll try to answer it. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and I'm gonna go for lunch now. So subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys on the next episode.